For months, we have been reporting on a lack of transparency within the Kansas Department of Children and Families.
And now we're seeing results. 41 Action News investigator Jessica McMaster is here with information, a bill that will require the agency to release records following a child's death, Jessica.
Yeah, Rhiannon, when a child dies from abuse in Kansas, as you know, rarely does anyone know if Department for Children and Families did what it should to protect the child. But that could soon change.
Why are you doing that?
A child's death so horrific, it broke the hearts of people all across the country and left the little boy's grandmother devastated.
He left this world feeling so unloved, and he was loved.
Adrian Jones was abused to death by his father and stepmother. In the years following, his grandmother, Judy Conway, battled Kansas Department for Children and Families for his file. She eventually got it from us.
That has just blown my mind, made me really terribly angry.
After reporting on multiple tragedies kept secret by DCF.
So what has Kansas learned from Adrian, Makai, and Evan? And what's being done to prevent it from happening again?
Lawmakers in the House have unanimously passed this bill that states when a child dies, DCF shall release a summary of facts surrounding the child's death, including all hotline calls made to the agency.
Our job is to be public servants.
Newly appointed Secretary for DCF, Gina Meyer-Hummel, told us in a previous interview she plans to run a more transparent agency.
Where possible and where we've made missteps, we absolutely plan to talk about it.
I spoke to Adrian's grandmother. She says she's happy with the bill, that families should not have to battle for records, and that the bill is a step in the right direction. The bill now moves to the Senate for approval. As for Adrian's dad and stepmom, they were convicted in his death. I'm investigator Jessica McMaster, 41 Action News.